مولاي صل وسلم دائما ابدا على حبيبك.
And was this all of these contents, so it will make heavy to ummah, yeah, to sahaba, to do and to practice all of guidance from Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. So can you imagine if Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala in the same time, same period, and give Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam a lot of ayat about ibadah. Muhammad do zakah, Muhammad do salah, Muhammad do hajj, Muhammad do umrah in same period, in the same times. Can you imagine about what is a reaction from the sahaba? So they will feel it's heavy. It's not easy to practice a lot of this kind of ibadah and this command from Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. So to make a lot of kind of ibadah easier to do it or to do them, so Allah make it like period, right? Give Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala give the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam the first step to do salah. Muhammad do salah. When you complete this salah and you understand about the hikmah of salah, so the next step, Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala give ayat about zakat. Next step, give ayat about umrah, about hajj. So when you practice it and do it step by step, and you can learn it and you can feel a hikmah and deeply about what is benefit of salah, what is benefit of zakat. So you can do it from ibadah easier, yeah. So the next, you can feel about hikmah completely. So you can feel about rahmat Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala that give us rather than the ummah last period and the past before Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Jadi teman-teman sekalian, apa hikmah yang pertama di balik turunnya ayat Al-Quran? Ya, tidak sekaligus tapi bertahap. Hikmah yang pertama memberikan kemudahan bagi umat Nabi Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam untuk menerima risalah ibadah. Anda bayangkan kalau satu waktu turun sekaligus, Muhammad kerjakan solat, Muhammad zakat, Muhammad haji, Muhammad umrah, ya, dan seterusnya, maka bagaimana perasaan kita dalam menerima ibadah saat yang bersamaan? Maka oleh Allah ringankan ini untuk mengerjakan secara sempurna sehingga paham hikmahnya, paham kemudian maknanya, bisa merasakan kenikmatannya, dan ini bagian dari rahmat Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala yang tidak diberikan pada umat-umat sebelumnya.
Kanu qalilan min al-lail ma yahja'un wa bil ashari hum yastaghfirun.